We want to create a scatter plot for the given data that compares speed in miles per hour to the stopping distance in feet. Once we create the scatter plot, we can decide which type of function would be a good model for the data. So the first step is to scale the axes to accommodate the given data. Notice how the speed ranges from 0 to 55, and we'll actually label the x-axis from 0 to 80. So half of 80 would be 40. Half of 40 is 20, so this would be 60. Again, this is in miles per hour. And then for the stopping distance, the maximum value is 182. I'm actually going to scale this to 240. So this would be 120, this would be 60, this would be 180. Again, this was 120 here. And now we'll go ahead and plot the data as ordered pairs. So the first point is 0, 0, which would be the origin. Next we have the point 20, 41, be somewhere in here. Then we have 35, 76, so somewhere in here. 45, 132, somewhere in here. And the last point would be 55, 183. Somewhere here. So looking at how the data is behaving, this does look like the right side of a parabola that opens up. So what we're going to do now is perform quadratic regression to come up with an equation to model this data. And to do this, we'll be using the TID4 graphing calculator. To do this, we'll press STAT and then Enter, and then we'll enter in the data. If you have old data in here, you can clear it by going to the top of the column, pressing clear, and then enter. This is just like Excel, so we'll press 0, enter, 20, enter, and so on. Press the right arrow, and now we'll enter in the second column. So the first column will be the x values, the second column will be the y values. And before we perform the regression though, we do want to set up the axes like we did on the scatter plot. So we'll press Window. Notice how I've already set this up, except that I reduced the x minimum to negative 10 and the y minimum to negative 20. I did this so that we could make sure that we saw the origin on the screen of the calculator. Now what we'll do is make sure that we have the scatter plot on, and then we'll perform the regression. Because we have the data in L1 and L2, there's a very quick way to turn on the scatter plot. If we press Y equals, press the up arrow, see how it's blinking on plot 1, and then we press Enter, and then the down arrow. Now if we press Graph, we have the scatter plot that matches our scatter plot by hand. And now we're going to perform quadratic regression and graph it right on top of this scatter plot. So we'll go back to the home screen. We're going to press STAT. Right arrow to calc. Option 5 is quadratic regression. And before we press enter, we want to store this equation in Y1. So we're going to press vars, right arrow once, enter. Notice how Y1 is already selected, so we'll press enter again, and then enter again. So here's our quadratic model. Notice how r squared is very close to 1, so it's a very good fit. But also, if we press y equals, this equation is already stored in y1. So if we press graph, we can see the graph of the model right on top of the scatter plot. And you can see it's a very good fit. Now let's take a look at a couple of questions. And we will answer these from the calculator. So for the quadratic equation, we'll go ahead and just say on calculator. So first we want to predict the stopping distance of a car traveling 75 miles per hour. Well, remember, the speed would be the x-coordinate, so we want to evaluate the function when x is equal to 75. So go back to the calculator. So we'll use the table to do this, but let's first press second window so we can adjust the table set. What we want to do is go down to the independent variable and change this to ask. So we'll press enter, and now when we go to the table by pressing second graph, we can type in any x value that we want, and we want to know what the stopping distance would be when x is 75, so I'll press 75 and then enter. So it's going to be approximately 318.2 feet. So f of 75 is approximately equal to 318.2 feet. And I am assuming they want us to round to the tenths. The next question is, if a stopping distance is 220 feet, what was the speed based upon the model? So in this case, they're asking us, what would x be if we know the stopping distance was 220 feet? So in the first example, we were determining the y value. And for number two, we're given the y value. We want to determine the x value. And again, let's do this on the graphing calculator. We could play around with values of x until y was equal to 220, but that would probably take forever. Let's go and take a look at our graph. We want to determine the x-coordinate when y is equal to 220. So what we can do is go back to y equals, go down to y2, and type in y2 equals 220. This should be a horizontal line passing through the y-axis at 220. So if we graph this, notice how the x value we want would be the x coordinate of this point of intersection, because this is where the stopping distance would be 220 feet. So if we press second trace, this brings up the calculate menu, and we want to find the intersection of those two functions. So we'll press 5, and then from here we can just press enter 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And we can see that the x coordinate of this point of intersection is approximately 61.1 miles per hour. Again, rounding to the tenths place value. So in this video, we use the TID4 graphing calculator to do this type of problem, but of course you can use other types of software. Here's a graph from another software that I use that shows the scatter plot and the graph of the model. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.